So without further ado, I want to introduce you to Aaron Karpaty, who is going to do his tech demo for Jiffel now. So over to you, Aaron.
All right.
Good luck.
Thanks. Hi, everyone. A few of you I've known for a long time. So super happy to be here. We only have 15 minutes, and I can talk about this stuff all day long. But at the end of the day, Jiffel Now is a meeting automation platform for events. We don't schedule and manage events. We schedule and manage meetings at events. So all of the sales meetings, executive meetings, demos, rooms, locations, agendas of those meetings, that's what Jiffel Now focuses on. We have lots of great partners that manage Reg and event apps and lead gen. We don't do that. We integrate with all of those people. Our whole goal is, how do we drive meetings that's going to help create an advanced pipeline and drive revenue and growth for the company and justify the ROI and event spend across the total portfolio? So what I'm going to demo today quickly is outbound and inbound. So think of this as sales reps outbound 6 to 8 weeks prior to an event are working to schedule meetings with prospects, customers, partners, pulling in the right executives or experts from their companies to have the right types of meetings, like sales meeting, executive meeting, demos, AR, PR, right? Or maybe inviting them to some sessions that we're going to be in sessions and then convert them to meetings. Also that we can drive the right outbound engagements that are going to drive pipeline. And then inbound, how do we give links to the marketing team to put in their email campaigns, social posts, sponsorship portal pages for people to click on a link and request a meeting with that company or sign up for a demo or a session? So outbound, we're driving engagements. Inbound, we're driving engagements, and we're maximizing meetings that drive pipeline and revenue for the company, okay? So now one of the excited things I wanted to show since I was going to be at a tech show was how reps could do this never leaving Salesforce, right? Because sales reps don't want to go use event software. Right? This is why we still partner with the big registration platforms, is because we have the use cases of the reps not having to be in event software, integrated with the event stack and the sales and marketing stack. So for the sales rep to come in and say, hey, I want to look at one of my accounts or opportunities or contacts, and I can come in and just click a button that's going to bring in the visual force page of Jiffel Now. If I went to Jiffel Now, I would have the home page where I see any of my events that are launched that have meeting programs. But for the sales team, I could do that with them never leaving Salesforce. So a rep could come in right within Salesforce to RSA and say, hey, I want to book a meeting. Well, what kind of meeting? All customizable. Pick that type of meeting. It's already got the account. Hey, is there a current opportunity associated with this meeting? Because now I'm going to be able to track not just pipeline created, but pipeline advanced as a result of those meetings at the event. So then I go to the next steps. It takes me to the book meeting page where, and I can do some cool things here. Like I can make it so that if I picked executives, I only see my executive staff that I want to book into meetings. If I would have picked demos, I could have picked a topic and then it would have showed me any of the experts that matched those topics. But I can come in here and I can pick the people. I can go to the external link and pick any of the customers or partners that are contacts that are from with that account in Salesforce. So I don't have to add them, but we also do some killer integrations with RainFocus and others, where I can pull in the event reg list. And not only will this say, hey, this is a contact associated in Salesforce, but in blue letters, it'll say registered, right? So you're only booking people into meetings that are actually registered for the event. So I can add my external people, and then I can come over and pick a time slot, which is automatically going to give me the available room that's available at that time. And I can have it so that when I pick executive meetings, I see executive suites. When I pick demos, I see demo stations. So I can map the people and locations to meeting types and or topics. So I pick the location. I go to the next steps. We can also, if you're doing any kind of hybrid stuff, we can integrate with Zoom, Teams, WebEx to add links from their Zoom account automatically and support hybrid. But here is where you get these meeting request forms, which is, hey, what's this meeting about? And this is, instead of having to fill this out as the rep does, it's all pulling in from Salesforce and automating it. So it's streamlining all of that data. Things like, you know, what kind of opportunity is this? What's the revenue amount? So now this is going to create the briefing doc automatically that goes in the body of the calendar invite to the executives being invited. And that eliminates all the manual work to create briefing docs. And then I hit submit. And the meeting gets booked at any time. If the rep needs to reschedule anything, they can, never leaving Salesforce, and updated calendar invites go out. So super easy for the sales rep, but all set up on the back end to meet the event requirements, okay? And all of that comes out into to Outlook or GCal. And the internal people get a calendar invite with the confidential information about the meeting, where the external people get a calendar invite without it, right? And anything's changed, updated calendar invites go out. So I can make last minute changes on the fly and everybody's notified. Now, that's the outbound. The inbound is that every event that gets launched gets what we call an inbound request page. So you can put the link or a button or the form, you can iframe just this form within a registration platform or mobile app so that you don't have to leave the environment that you're in. And the customer could say, hey, I wanna get a demo. Okay, well, what topics are you interested in? It's rolling a little slow. What topics are you interested in? Answer some customized qualifying questions, go to the next steps, and see an available time slot where we have a product expert that can talk about that topic. Click the time, automatically processes, picks the right room that's available, the product expert, and gets calendar invites out. Or they could say, hey, I'm gonna pick up the three slots. I could do this on this day, and I could do this and this on the next day, and submits this as a request. And then what happens is the events team gets notified that they have inbound requests, takes them to the inbound request page. They can view those incoming ones and process them, adding the right internal people, adding the right room, and booking the meeting, okay? External people could also sign up for sessions. So if I went back to that page, one of those engagement types could have been booth tour, round table, right? Like registration will normally handle all the regular sessions, but sometimes there's like guided booth tours or group demos at certain times, and they will use Jiffel now for that because we have the workflow management and the ability to map to different topics and regions, et cetera. So now that I have booked outbound and inbound engagements and maximized that across my entire event portfolio. Like if I'm going to an IBM Think and I'm gonna book 4,000 meetings and 50 booth tours a day, right? That's one thing. But if I'm gonna go to a field event where I'm gonna book 10 meetings, it's still creating an advancing pipeline that I need to track and report on and justify the spend across my events, right? And that's good for all of us that are a cost center to those events, that they can track in the, all of that pipeline associated with those meetings. Okay? So any questions? Oh, the last thing I'll give you really quick. I'm not going to go into all the management functionality that an event manager has on managing all these meetings on site because I just don't have time, but they definitely will get what they spend weeks doing, pulling into a spreadsheet all of the data right at their fingerprints, pre-event, during event, post-event, on how many meetings have been booked, how many outbound versus inbound, how much pipeline is associated with it, what's the leaderboard on sales reps booking meetings, etc. So if you guys want to see any more demoing, come and see us in the back corner over there. Thanks.
Oh, okay. We have a question here at the front.
Thank you. Hey, how's it going? One quick question. So as an event organizer, I know one thing that I'm always thinking about is how to make this easier for somebody who is thinking about their event attendance holistically, you know, and finding this in some other place. Have you explored any ability to kind of pull this functionality into session catalogs on any given, you know, or is that on the radar at all?
Yes. At the exhibitor level, but not at the show, right? So I wouldn't go to CES and be part of that, but I may be a part of Dell World or IBM Think, pulling in the session catalog so that we can map the experts to all of that stuff as well. Make sense?
Yeah.
Any other questions? Well, thank you so much, Aaron. That was amazing. Thank you.
Awesome. Thanks.